If you were the NHL, I want to know how you would handle this scenario. It's 15 minutes to the first puck drop, and two of your three officials are complete no-shows.
They just don't show up.
They just don't show up.
I would hold a contest before.
You would hold a...
Yep, I would hold a fan contest, and
okay.
I would come over the loudspeaker, and I'd be like, hello, Milwaukee,
yeah.
That's where we are.
Yeah, we're in Milwaukee.
They have a team. And I'd be like, we need fans who really know this game and know how to skate.
Sure.
It's brilliant.
It's really fun. You're not too far off from what actually happened.
What actually
because
happened?
This actually happened.
This happened?
Once in NHL history. It's January 15th, 1983.
Ooh.
The Hartford Whalers, they're hosting the New Jersey Devils.
Mm-hmm.
And this huge snowstorm happens, this big blizzard in the Northeast. And two of the officials who were supposed to show up to this game just cannot make it. And the one linesman, so you get two linesmen and one referee back
right.
then. One of the linesmen is like, screw it, I'm gonna do it. I will ref this game. But the NHL has a rule mm-hmm. in the rule book for specifically this scenario.
Oh,
and
I'm
so excited.
What's...
have with me the NHL rule book, which has the rule in it.
Oh
and I really
God.
Think you're gonna love this. So he turns to the rule book, unable to continue, rule 31, section 11. If through misadventure or sickness, the referees and linesmen appointed are prevented from appearing,
mm-hmm.
the league will make every attempt to find suitable replacement officials. Otherwise, the managers or coaches of the two clubs shall agree on referees and linesmen.
You know what I bet that came from? I bet they had refs who would get so like messed up before game, who would be
That's
like at a
thinking.
Bar before, and then they're like, I can have one in skate, and then they have like six.
They get destroyed.
And just get like totally wasted. Well, you know Gary.
You,
like,
know Gary.
You know Gary's not gonna show.
He's
and they're
such
like,
a pain.
There's so many Garys.
There's a Gary in this story, isn't
it? Is there really?
Fact. Swear to God, hand
hockey,
to God.
Big hockey name.
You can pretty much just pick whoever you want.
So
you can be like, you in the third row. Put the nachos down.
Right, so it's actually pretty much exactly what I said.
It's almost exactly what you said. You wanted to make it a contest, but
yeah,
you never specified what the actual contest would be.
So I don't know what the contest would be, but I know that they'd know how to skate.
Well, they didn't do that in Hartford. They went to each coach of each team, uh-huh. and they decided to pick a player who was not going to play that day.
Oh, that's so smart.
Yes. You already know how to play.
Right.
Only one of them's name is Gary. And that was Gary Howitt.
I can't believe there's actually a Gary
There's a
in this
real
story.
Gary in the story. Gary Howitt was a forward for the Devils who had injured his knee. Lace him up, Gary. You're going to be one linesman. And then they went to Mickey Vulcan on the Whalers,
okay.
who was a defenseman. They literally had them throw on practice sweats and black jerseys that they had lying around inside the arena, which, by the way, is
yeah.
mostly empty. Less than 5,000 people showed up. It was like 4,800 something actually showed up to the game.
That's
so they
right.
still have to play a game.
That makes sense.
And the rule book says if there are people around
hockey.
Who can do it, hockey never sleeps.
It'll happen. So how'd it go?
So this guy, Mickey Vulcan, was like, took it very seriously. And at one point, he actually kicked out someone on the Whalers from the circle in a faceoff because he was trying to cheat. He was like, dude, not on my watch. Not happening. He took it like really seriously.
That's really endearing.
Yeah,
something very
isn't it?
Moving. I'm very moved by that.
Yeah. They only had to do one period before the real refs managed to make it through the snowstorm and showed up.
Oh, so they did
At
show
which
up?
Point, yeah, they showed up.
Okay.
And according to the rules, once the real refs show up, you have to abdicate the throne and
of
let them come
of
refdom. Knowing that this rule exists,
mm-hmm.
would you have any interest in being an NHL ref?
Yeah.
If duty called, would you do it?
Oh my God, I would answer in like 2 seconds for sure.
Okay, I'm gonna give you the rule book.
I should study up.
You should study up in case it happens. You should start going to more games. Although I am concerned
mm-hmm.
that I'm gonna read a news report that like a van full of NHL officials met some awful fate because they had their brake lines cut or something.
Ryan, when you have a dream, you do whatever it takes to achieve it.
I'm happy to report that Charlotte is now under constant surveillance and is a threat to nobody. Thanks a lot for watching Weird Rules. It's this new series we're doing where I'm telling my buddies fun stories that have developed from exactly that, weird rules. So if you know a story like this one, leave it in the comments and maybe you'll see it.